गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट. सी इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव सीन रिएक्टिविटी ऑफ कार्बोनिल कंपाउंड्स. ओके, नाउ सी वी विल सी रिएक्शंस ऑफ अल्डिहाइड एंड कीटोन्स. रिएक्शंस ऑफ अल्डिहाइड एंड कीटोन्स. इन दैट फर्स्ट रिएक्शन वी हैव टू सी, फर्स्ट टाइप ऑफ रिएक्शन वी हैव टू सी एडिशन रिएक्शन. फर्स्ट टाइप ऑफ रिएक्शन इज वॉट? एडिशन रिएक्शन. एंड in that we have to see first reaction with hydrogen cyanide. Reaction with what? Hydrogen cyanide. Let us see reaction with hydrogen cyanide. Okay, so for example if you take a aldehyde benzaldehyde and if it is reacted with hydrogen cyanide, isn't it? See here, this is what? Delta H plus, and CN is what? Delta minus. Okay. And this is what? A carbonyl group. And we know reactivity of carbonyl group. So this carbonyl is electron deficient. It is having carbonyl carbon is electron deficient, which is having delta positive charge, and oxygen is having delta negative charge. So there will be a addition of this hydrogen cyanide. There will be a addition of this hydrogen cyanide across this carbon oxygen double bond. So oxygen will get bonded to what? H. Okay, that is delta H plus, and carbonyl carbon will get bonded to delta CN minus. In this way, this double bond will get converted to single bond after addition. So what product you will get? PHCHOH CN H. So this is what? Benzaldehyde cyanohydrine. Benzaldehyde cyanohydrine. Okay, now let us see second example. Suppose if we have reacted acetone with hydrogen cyanide, okay, either you may write it like this or you may write it like this. So what you will get? You will get acetone cyanohydrine. This will be what? Acetone cyanohydrine, isn't it? Now see next reaction we will see. Suppose if we have reacted acetaldehyde with hydrogen cyanide, what we will get? There will be a formation of acetaldehyde cyanohydrine. Okay, what is this? Acetaldehyde cyanohydrine. So this is what the reaction of aldehyde and ketone with what? Hydrogen cyanide. Okay, hydrogen cyanide will undergo addition reaction across this carbon oxygen double bond, that is a carbonyl group, to form a adduct. Okay, that is what? Addition product which is called also adduct. And here we will get benzaldehyde cyanohydrine, here we will get acetone cyanohydrine, and here we will get what? Acetaldehyde cyanohydrine. Now, what is the importance of this reaction? What is the importance of this reaction? See, if we hydrolyze, okay, what is the importance of this reaction that we are writing here? I am writing here. If we hydrolyze this reaction, sorry, this reaction product, if we hydrolyze this product, isn't it? That means by reacting with hydrochloric acid, water, diluted HCl, okay. So what we will get, see here, we will get what is this? Lactic acid. So we can prepare lactic acid. We can prepare lactic acid from acetaldehyde through reaction with what? Hydrogen cyanide. Isn't it? Similarly, suppose if we hydrolyze this benzaldehyde cyanohydrin, what we will get? See, we will get this carboxylic acid, and it is called mandelic acid. It is one of the useful acid in the synthesis of some drug intermediate, isn't it? So we can get mandelic acid from benzaldehyde through what? Reaction with what? Hydrogen cyanide. So this is what the importance of this reaction we can say, isn't it? Now let us see next reaction. Reaction with sodium bisulfite. Reaction with sodium bisulfite, NaHSO3. Okay, NaHSO3, sodium bisulfite. What is the structure of sodium bisulfite? See, this is what the structure of sodium bisulfite, NaHSO3. So we will react benzaldehyde with sodium bisulfite, isn't it? We will react benzaldehyde with what? Sodium bisulfite. See here, we are having O minus. We are having O minus, and sulfur is also having a lone pair of electron. Sulfur atom of NaHSO3 is also having a lone pair of electron. But this sulfur atom is more nucleophilic. This sulfur atom is what? More nucleophilic than this O minus, isn't it? Hence, there will be a addition of sodium bisulfite through sulfur nucleophile, not oxygen nucleophile. So what we will get? We will get a product in which carbonyl carbon will get bonded with what? Sulfur, not oxygen. So what product we will get here? See here, we will get SO3 Na, benzaldehyde bisulfite adduct. बेंजेडियाइड, सोडियम बाइसल्फाइड एडक्ट. ओके व्हाट वी विल गेट, बेंजेडियाइड सोडियम बाइसल्फाइड एडक्ट. See here, we can say this proton got bonded to what? Electronegative oxygen of carbonyl group, and rest of the part, that is SO3Na, it got bonded to what? Carbonyl carbon of carbonyl group. This is what the addition of NaHSO3 across benzaldehyde carbonyl group. Okay, similarly, if we react acetone with sodium bisulfite, what product we will get? We will get acetone sodium bisulfite adduct. Acetone sodium bisulfite adduct, isn't it? Now similarly, if we react acetaldehyde with sodium bisulfite, what product we will get? Again here we will get acetaldehyde sodium bisulfite adduct. Acetaldehyde sodium bisulfite adduct, isn't it? Acetaldehyde sodium bisulfite adduct. Now let us see next point. So this was the reaction of sodium bisulfite to what? Carbonyl compounds like aldehyde and ketone. So here sulfur is better nucleophile than oxygen. This what we have to remember. So sulfur can form bond with carbonyl carbon. Okay, sulfur can form bond with what? Carbonyl carbon, as sulfur is better nucleophile than O minus, isn't it? Now what is the importance of this reaction? See, these are what? Aldehyde and ketone. Okay, so aldehyde and ketone can form a bisulfite adduct. Aldehyde and ketone can form bisulfite adduct by reaction with what? Sodium bisulfite. Through reaction with what? Sodium bisulfite. Now this adduct, what the adduct we got? Acetaldehyde, acetone, benzaldehyde, sodium bisulfite adduct. These adduct are what? They are crystalline solids. They are what? Crystalline solids. So we can easily separate aldehyde and ketones. We can easily separate aldehyde and ketones from other organic compounds, isn't it? Suppose other organic compound, like suppose there is a mixture of benzaldehyde and oxidized benzoic acid, isn't it? Suppose we are having a bottle of benzaldehyde, but due to presence of air, there is what? Air oxidation will take place, and benzaldehyde, some part of the benzaldehyde will got converted to what? Benzoic acid. So we can just add sodium bisulfite in that mixture of benzaldehyde and benzoic acid. Okay, so benzaldehyde will react with this sodium bisulfite, isn't it? So that sodium bisulfite, isn't benzaldehyde will get reacted with what? Sodium bisulfite. And we can separate this benzaldehyde sodium bisulfite adduct from that mixture, and we can again convert this product, that is this byproduct, this bisulfite adduct, into aldehyde. Into what? Aldehyde. Back through reaction with what? H3O+. That means suppose if we carry out reaction with dilute HCl or dilute acid, it will again give what? Acetone and sodium bisulfite. Similarly, this will give acetaldehyde and sodium bisulfite. Okay, that means we can again convert this adduct into our starting material, aldehyde and ketone, isn't it? So this is what the importance of this reaction with what? Sodium bisulfite. This is what the importance of reaction with sodium bisulfite. Now let us see next reaction. Reaction with alcohols. Now let us see what is the reaction of carbon nucleophile with alcohols. You know the structure of alcohol. General formula of alcohol is what? ROH. See, alcohol are also good nucleophile, as there is ROH, that means alkoxy group RO minus is a good nucleophile what? For carbonyl compounds in presence of acidic medium. Okay, hence this reaction is occur. See, for example, if we react benzaldehyde with 1 mole of ethanol in presence of concentrated hydrochloric acid. What we will get? See, there will be what? Addition. There will be what? Addition. Oxygen is delta minus and proton is delta plus. That is ethoxy group. Ethoxy group CH3CH2O minus. Okay, this is having delta minus charge and this hydrogen is having delta positive charge. So there will be a addition of this ethanol molecule across this carbon oxygen double bond. So carbon oxygen double bond, that is carbonyl group, will get converted to what? Will get converted to single bond after addition. So what we will get? Sorry. This what we will get as a product. Okay, if we react 1 mole of ethanol, if we react 1 mole of alcohol with what? Aldehyde or ketone, we will get such type of product, addition product. And this is what? Hemiacetal. So this is formed through what? Addition reaction. This is formed through what? Addition reaction. See, this compound alcohol is undergoing what? Addition reaction across this carbon oxygen double bond to get what? This hemiacetal product. Okay, now if we react this benzaldehyde, okay, with second mole of ethanol molecule, with second mole of ethanol molecule in presence of concentrated HCl, what product we will get? Let us see. Now there will be a substitution. See, now there will be a what? Substitution. What is here? Substitution. What is here? Addition. So what product we will get here? This OH functionality will get substituted by ethoxy group. okay, it will get substituted by ethoxy group. So we will get two ethoxy group now here. So this is acetal. This is what? Acetal of benzaldehyde. We can say this is acetal of benzaldehyde, this is hemiacetal of benzaldehyde. So this what product we will get after this reaction, that is reaction with alcohol. Now suppose if we react ketone, if we react ketone with ethanol molecule in presence of concentrated HCl, okay, so again there will be addition of this ethanol across this carbonyl group, so what we will get? We will get this product, isn't it? When we will react acetone with 1 mole of ethanol in presence of concentrated HCl, so there will be addition of this ethoxy group and this H plus, okay, across this carbonyl group to get this product, and this is called hemiketal. This is called what? Hemiketal, isn't it? Now in next step, suppose if we react this, that means if we carry out reaction of acetone with 2 moles, okay, with 2 moles of alcohol, or we can say excess of alcohol, so what will happen? Concentrated HCl. So there will be a formation of OET, OET, there is formation of ketal as a product. So here what we will get? Ketal as a product, and this is what? This is what? Addition. Okay, here what we can say? Here there is what? Substitution. In second step there is substitution, and in first step there is what? Addition, isn't it? So this is what? Ketal of acetone. This is what? Hemiketal of acetone. This is what? Hemiacetal of benzaldehyde, or this is what? Acetal of benzaldehyde, isn't it? Now suppose, for example, if we react acetone with ethylene glycol, okay, in presence of concentrated hydrochloric acid, what product we will get? Let us see. Here we will get cyclic ketal. What we will get? Cyclic ketal. When we will react acetone with what? Ethylene glycol in presence of concentrated HCl. See here, both the alcoholic functionality, that is both hydroxyl group, are present in same molecule, okay, so there will be a formation of such type of cyclic structure when we will react such type of compound with either with aldehyde or ketone. So we will get cyclic ketal in this reaction, isn't it? Now let us see next point. I think here we have seen reaction with hydrogen cyanide, reaction with sodium bisulfite, and reaction with alcohol. isn't it? I hope you have understood all these reactions. Okay, we'll stop here. Wish you all the best. Wish you happy learning. Thank you very much.